जुलाई बरकातुहु, वेलकम बैक अगेन टू माय क्लास स्टूडेंट्स. वी आर जस्ट डूइंग विद आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज नाउंस. वी आर डूइंग कॉन्क्रीट एंड अब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउंस. सो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट नाउंस? नेम्स ऑफ थिंग्स दैट यू कैन सी, दैट यू कैन विजुअलाइज, दैट यू कैन सी, टच, दैट यू कैन टच सम थिंग्स. नो हियर टेस्ट और स्मेल आर कॉल्ड एज कॉन्क्रीट नाउंस. Here the five senses come, students, that is see, touch, hear, taste and smell are called as concrete nouns. For example, chocolate. You can touch a chocolate, you can taste a chocolate, even you can smell the chocolate. No, now for example, dog also, it's a living thing. You can touch a dog, you can feel the touching of a dog. That is nothing but a concrete noun. Now we can go to the abstract noun. What are the abstract nouns? Nouns of things that you cannot see, touch, hear, taste or smell are called as abstract nouns. Here the five senses does not come. It does not include the five senses. But abstract noun mostly consists of feelings. The feelings that cannot be expressed. Now for example, love. How much do you love your mother? Can you express that one? Or how much does your father love you? Can your father express in terms of words? No, he can't express that in terms of words. Happiness. Now we are happy that you are just listening to some jokes. Can you just express your happiness? No, it cannot be expressed. Pride. Can the pride be expressed? Yes, it can be expressed, but it cannot be measured in terms of feelings like beauty, intelligence. Pride can't be expressed in terms of quantity. Now for example, here tick the correct option to say if these words are concrete nouns or abstract nouns. Now this first word is thirst. Can you just feel that you are feeling thirsty? Yes, you feel that you are feeling thirsty. Can you just touch your thirst? Or can you see your thirst? No, it cannot be done. So which sentence it is? So which word it is? It comes under abstract noun. Now for example, river. As I told you all already in the last, that is countable and non-countable. This can be written in river comes under concrete noun because you can touch the water of the river. You can see the river. Don't you see the river? Yes, it comes under concrete noun. Now, hunger. Hunger, it's a feeling. So, it comes under abstract noun. Now, see this picture here. It's a concrete noun. A concrete noun is a noun you can experience or detect with your five senses. Now, for example, taste. That is, you can taste the flavor, you can taste the food, you can taste the sweetness, you can taste the saltness, the things which comes under taste. See, you can see a cloud, you can see a rainbow. Now, hear, you can hear a noise, you can hear a thunder. Next, smell. What can you smell? If your mother is cooking a delicious non-veg dish or vegetarian dish, can you not hear smell that things? You just go to your mother and you tell, Mama, biryani, today is biryani. Can you smell now? Yes, that comes under smelling. Now touch. You can just touch a pencil. You can touch a pencil. You can touch a soap. You can touch the sand. You can touch the cushions, the soft cushions. That and all comes under concrete nouns. Now for abstract nouns. An abstract noun is something you cannot detect with your five senses or the senses. Abstract nouns are the things which comes under feelings. Now for example, feelings of love, hateness, pride, joy, happiness, anger or ideas. Such ideas like you dream, you have knowledge, you have opinion of your own, that and all comes under abstract nouns.
Now let us come to collective nouns. The word here collective only tells that a group. Some nouns are used to refer to a group of persons, animals or thing or as one unit. These are called as collective nouns or they are called as collective nouns. Now for example, an army of ants. Many ants are moving, no? So you should tell that. Not many ants, you should tell that. An army of ants. You should tell that. An army of ants. Did you get students? A bunch of flowers. A pack of wolves. A school of fish. You can just watch one picture of this one.
Look at the picture here. Here are just referring to a group. They are referring to a group. Now for example, a class of students. A troop of dancers.
Now here is an exercise given for you. Match the collective nouns with the common nouns. Here it is. A bunch of. Can computer comes in a bunch? No. Buffaloes? No. Bees? No. Kittens? No. Bananas. It is a bunch of bananas. Do the rest by yourself. Do the activities by yourself. That is page number 9. Do the exercise F. Exercise G. That is exercise G is change the underlined nouns in each sentence to make new sentences. They must match the picture given. Now here the first sentence is Tony is washing his face. The underlined words here are Tony. The next picture you can see. You should change Tony. I'm giving an example. Mr. Sharma is washing his. Now here face. It's a thing. I'm changing the face into clothes. That is Mr. Sharma is washing his clothes. Did you get students? Do the rest of it by yourself. H mean what kind of nouns are these words? Take the right answer. This you should know. So much of explanation is done. Do it by yourself. H, I, J. All this revision to be done by yourself. Did you get student? The first chapter nouns is completed. Complete from page number 5 to page number 11. Jazakallahu khair.